So this is Wednesday the 20th of March and it's snowing away, and tomorrow we're off to Kenya. Hard to imagine, isn't it? About 6:30 in the morning. So here we are, all ready to go to Kenya. We're going for the comedy there, Tim. This is Holland after all, it's a drugstore.
The beach fire scare on beach. We make fun of that. Make a fob me lose all.
This is the living room. Pies is too. Fireplace. This is where Heather and I are sleeping. I think Maureen is sleeping in there, so we won't disturb her. Bathroom.
But now he hasn't seen me and my family since Martin and Dean were home last summer.
Okay.
to celebrate his third birthday.
Okay. Yeah. So it's this is the back garden. A little walk around. That's our water tank. And here is the front garden. Melter's sand pit. Big, big house. This is the front entrance up here. There's the main entrance of the house there. And this is the new Jeep. Ooh, look at that. Looking pretty snazzy. Nice one. No, boy car, girl car. No, okay.
Yeah?
Boy,
yeah.
Yeah, plenty to keep us going for the whole trip. 2,000 shillings altogether.
145.
Sure. Well? Yeah. Martin og Rea har masser af musik, så hun er god til at spille DJ.
They put the bumps. It's like, why don't you just let us go? There are bumps on this road. At least
so
the first
people
part.
Can cross.
Yeah, it's the first part they have them. But that's because, you know, they've started to put up these walking bridges, but people don't use them. So you still have them walking across. Okay, Toyota, you go. Yuki, 194.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fully loaded.
Now we're down to one lane.
Behind him a tattoo.
Again.
Worst scenario you want to be in. I'm just waiting for them to come up so we can go. I noticed they all drive around with this sleeve on it. It's pelme something.
I'm not sure which one.
It's like, well, they all have a leaf of some sort on it.
Oh, it's the, from the maize. It's the,
yeah,
isn't it?
But I think it's got to be some religious sign at one point. Oh, let me go get this guy.
Mount Kenya ahead of us. No idea really where we are, but there's Manta Mountain. Sarah and Luna. So we've turned off towards Nanyuki now, right?
Yeah.
We're no longer on the road up to Nyeri, we've turned off to Nanyuki. Safaricom is all over the place. So is Nescaf.
I think they get paid to paint there and things like that.
But I bet it's a one-only payment.
As long as
still
it's colorful.
Yeah, nice, they got a new brand new paint job. Karichu. Reach your church we just passed. These are all the weaver birds. And the thunder on the horizon. Lovely sound, isn't it?
Yeah. Probably be woken up by something like that tomorrow. Have you filmed the sign over there, Christopher?
Yes, darling.
Yeah.
So this is a pelican house where we'll be staying the next couple of nights. And let's have a quick tour. Facilities. This is the main bedroom, a one room, the leopard up the top there, and out the view out the window. Hopefully this evening there'll come some animals to the waterhole. This is the other room, also with windows of the waterhole. And there's three staff, as far as we know, Joshua, Helen, and Elizabeth. They'll be looking after us. There's the other room, similar deal, a little bit smaller. Also with its own bath room. Very nice. A view out of Mount Kenya on that side.
Do
you have snakes here?
Yes, it's not.
Snakes?
Yes. Not dangerous.
Not dangerous. And a great big sa. Oh, did everyone the coffin? In the kitchen. Everything you need. What more could you want? It's very sad. Santa's on. And then the main part is out there, I guess. There's another house over here. I don't know quite what this is for. It's for heating the hot water, of course. We've got solar water on that one. Yeah, so this is where we're going to be Saturday and Sunday. Perfect. This is Mark, this is Shadow, and that's Mount Kenya.
It's the summer season, so it's obscured by the clouds again.
It's obscured by the clouds. Martin? It was on the back seat of one of the cars, I can't remember which one though.
Then it's got to be the Range Rover, because the back seat of the Jeep is full of people.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
Maria, you were there? Do you remember?
Yeah, the torch was in the back seat of the Range Rover.
Maybe it's still there.
Okay, well, I can stay there for now.
If you want to go get it.
That's
what
I'm going to
do.
Ja, det er ikke det, jeg siger, vel? Jeg siger bare, at sengen er noget lort. Jeg håber, jeg kommer til at sove godt i den. Jeg skal da dreje mig fuld af indtryk.
Martin, du sover helt fint.
Nej, jeg gør ikke. Jeg har ikke sengen den her. Jeg har fået den og galt. Nu er værd, for jeg sover din abe.
Du sover ikke. Har jeg ikke en abe?
Jeg prøver at sove din gazelle, numse. Gazelle, numse. Det er sådan, at jeg er mærkelig. Det er sådan, at jeg siger, at det er masser af brug til nye.
Can't wait to try out this bath tomorrow.
Okay, off and moving.
This is the reason the baboons are barking. It could be because I've seen something. Oh yeah, up in the trees. Sister. There's two lions ahead of us. One's on the right, which is gone down. Oh, dinner time.
Prøv at se, den kigger næsten op til os. Den mangler lige toppen.
Yeah, just the top there. Prepares
for a clear night.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
There's the peak. Yes, my dear. Thank you. This is just the waterhole where we're living. So we've just checked into the Outspan Hotel, and there's Mount Kenya covered in some clouds, and gotten some pretty good rates, I guess. We've got two rooms, 11 and 12, and these are the gardens, obviously, and we just found out that they're going to include lunch and dinner together with breakfast in the rates. And here's Sarah, and show you the size of these rooms. They're huge. Look at that. In the fireplace. And me. And there's the other two. Looking very happy. This is just covered, putting stuff on. There's the nurse on.
In the car, I think I left all my passports.
Yeah, to go. The bathroom. Sherry bar, open in the evenings. We're up in that hotel room up there. Lovely bougainvillea. Stretch quite a long way, and it is a great view when the clouds aren't there. This is where we sat last night. And this is the main dining room. Very helpful stuff. Hi. There's Martin's here. There's a business center. Martin.
Did you say Martin? I want to say.
You're famous. We're going to have a bit of it in there. Still camera.
Yes, it's my cousin's car. lost some cards in the previous boat. It was taking too much. But the guys are coming here.
Yeah, I have. I'm just going to film a little bit just so.
So where are you when you do come back to Kenya again?
Oh, we don't know. Maybe one day.
Yeah.
It's very much also for my husband. Of course we do this for ourselves, but it's also my husband's mother.
Yeah.
She's very old now, 84. She lives in Australia. It's her mother.
No, thanks much.
Just give me your contact. I'll show you the photo.
Okay, driving into Nyeri Center here.
And post office on the right.
Yep.
A little roundabout here, which had the sign for the Outspan, which we never saw. Until too late.
But we found the hotel anyway.
Yes.
And
we're just going to drive down and up.
Farman.
Yes, Martin. Er det hvad?
Vi skal ikke høre musik lige nu, Martin. Vi er ved at filme noget.
Please,
ikke lige nu, Martin. Kan
5 minutter? Jo. Thanks, girl.
Du må gerne igen om lidt. Okay, so we're coming down to... What? Anything special here?
No, I don't know. But interesting just to see the number of shops and the number of people and the number of cars and...
It's quite a busy...
It's thriving.
Busy.
Lots but it's still a very small town compared to, I guess, Nairobi. It doesn't seem like modernized, really.
You're going to take it to the inn, then turn around and come back on the other side?
Okay. Yeah. The Green Oak restaurant was recommended to us on the right-hand side there.
Mm-hmm. We never got there, no.
Coming up to a roundabout here. What's the price on the gas there?
It's about 119.10 Kenyan shillings for unleaded.
Okay.
And for kerosene,
that
doesn't matter. 89, yeah.
Yeah, 119 shillings a gallon, a litre.
Just doing the roundabout.
We'll cruise up to the top. Little market here. What's it? Tuesday morning. That's about 10:30.
10:30 Tuesday morning. I think it's a bus station or central pickup place here on the left.
Mutatas.
Yeah. Mutatas?
I think that's what they call.
I feel a little uncomfortable filming all these people without their consent, but
they're in a public place.
Still.
These two guys holding hands. Alright. Motherly love.
Or whatever.
And this is also 119, so there's not much difference in where to take.
No, I think we can take it either one else.
I'm going to actually take a left here so we can go up past the White Rhino.
Mm-hmm. There's a National Bank on the corner. It seems to be quite a few banks here, actually.
Yeah.
There's a Green Nut restaurant again on the left.
And a couple of old Peugeots.
A bit cloudy today, you just glimpse maybe the hills.
And if you look to the left there you can see a mosque.
Right here?
Yeah, and that old building there, Hannah.
Which one, darling?
The orange one.
The orange one, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
It's behind the sign right now. So
if we go up this other way, you can see just around to the right here, or straight ahead, the fire brigade.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to go up to the top of the hill.
And on that stretch we will
try not to run anyone over. And at the top of the hill up here, we'll see the White Rhino.
I hope your sound carries over here.
Yeah. And that's what it looks like today.
Ready?
Okay, so it's about 6 o'clock in the morning, Thursday morning, Easter Thursday, and we're getting ready to move out. So the trip down to Mombasa, the start, starts here. So we're off to a flying start, stuck in traffic. Hair-raising little exit through Nairobi.
Two roundabouts from hell.
Yeah.
At least.
Probably one of the most exciting little trips I've had for a long time in the car. We're moving ahead, we're not. Getting close to Savo and just going to tank up and have a wash the windscreens and change drivers, give Martin a break. He's been driving for 4 hours. We're halfway to the coast. And we're taking a small detour here, getting close to the coast on the way to Kilifi. Rhino Cement, doing a roaring business. Jambo!
Lots of different water sports.
Hello! So this is a house in Kilifi, and it's pretty stunning. It's the pool. Just awesome. There's so many photo opportunities here. That's just one little corner. This is the living room upstairs. It's all downstairs as well. This is the girls' room. That's where they'll be sleeping tonight. Together with Martin. And they've got their own bathroom, of course. Already put all their stuff away.
Good girls.
Big bathroom. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that. Quickly suck my stomach in. Hmm. We turn the lights on down here. That's what I... Yes, lovely. Thank you. So here we are at Watamu. There's Anna and the boats. Now we're at a place called Heavy Waves. The water's really warm. Kids think it's very funny. It's very pretty. And the sand is very white. My pretty girls, pretty black. Smelling good?
Yeah.
Nice, good to get fun.
Una.
Con Anna? Yeah. Yeah, really, so don't. Now we're in Fort Jesus and we're getting the start of a quick loon guided tour.
So this Portuguese, they were making trade from India, Chinese and Portugal. So when they go back, they were taking ivory and slaves.
And slaves.
Yes.
And how many? And out this way?
Yes. Now let's go to the church.
So we're driving out of Mombasa now. And it's 38 degrees outside, judging by the car temperature measure. 38 degrees this year. I don't think it's quite accurate, but it's at least 32. And we've just had a visit of tour of Port Jesus. And now we're going to see if we can find ice cream for the girls before we drive back up to Kilifi. So here we are at the grave of the kid's great-grandfather. And it says Paul Humphrey Clarke, born 17th of June 1891, died 17th of July 1946, day before my birthday, many years later. And we had some help finding it. Two African gentlemen gave us a hand, also guided us here to the entrance. As you can see, the grounds are pretty overgrown. The gardens haven't been looked after that well. But there's a fine tree giving him some shade. And we'll see what we can do just to tidy it up. And we've bought some roses, 20 roses, to put on the grave. We're literally 2 meters away from these lions.
Will you be okay?
Yeah, we'll be okay.
So, the perfect treat.
Mm.
Camp. Mm. No, very relaxed.
Drinking a beer?
Drinking what looks like a beer.
Sometimes the best is it's best for you to be stand up.
So what is it killed? No, somebody wants to chase it away and get its... So, we found a couple of leopards. And down here, there's a hyena waiting to see if he can steal their food. And here's one very happy little boy.
Thank you.